everyone. Welcome to Live Interactive English. This is Karen.
And I'm Matt.
Matt, I have a problem and I need your help.
What's the problem?
This morning when I was trying to look at myself in the mirror, and then my mirror was so dirty and I was trying to clean it and I just like, you know, wiped it with like tissue or I wiped it with my hand. It just became like, you know, like really, really cloudy and then it wasn't even clean. I couldn't see my beautiful face.
Well, you know what? I saw a useful tip the other day、that if you do not have any glass cleaning solution at home,
okay,
what you can do is use equal parts vinegar.
Vinegar?
Yeah, vinegar and water.
Uh-huh.
And mix those together and then use an old newspaper to wipe the glass.
Really?
Yeah.
Are you sure that will work?That will make my mirror nice and clean, right?
The internet said it works, so it must be true.
Okay, and then anything else?
And then another tip is if you use a whiteboard or blackboard eraser to wipe the mirror after, it will give it an extra shine.
You're kidding me, right?
I don't know. You'll have to try it yourself.
Okay.
I think you need to make sure it's a new whiteboard eraser, though, not one that's been used.
Okay, thank you for the tip, Matt. Okay, I'm going to go home and try it. But while we do that, and today we're going to be talking about the amazing story of glass, part two, and I just learned how to clean my mirror from Matt. Thank you so much.
No problem.
Glass is a common construction material because of its unique properties. For example, it's transparent, yet it's strong enough to resist the elements. Here are some fun facts about glass. Natural glass. Some glass is naturally formed by the heat of volcanoes. Our ancestors used this glass to make knives and jewelry. Recycled glass. Glass can be recycled repeatedly without losing quality.And it's one of the easiest materials to reuse. Most new glass contains some amount of recycled glass.
Today we're looking at part two of the amazing story of glass, right?
That's right. So last time we learned about how glass is made and some common ways that we use glass in our daily lives.
Mm-hmm. And today we're definitely going to learn more about this amazing material. Okay, glass is a common construction material because of its unique properties. For example, it's transparent, yet...It's strong enough to resist the elements. Okay, so when it's transparent, something is transparent, that means you can see right through it, right?
That's right. Just like a window, you can see from one side to the other because
exactly.
It's made of glass.
Mm-hmm. So. And it's strong enough to resist the elements. What does that mean when they say it's strong enough to resist the elements?
Well, in this case, when we talk about the elements, usually we're talking about the weather. So things like rain and wind and things that we have on a daily basis. So rain, wind, heat from the sun, these are the elements that glass needs to resist.
That's right. Okay, so here are some fun facts about glass.
Okay, so first, let's look at some vocabulary words.
Okay.
Our first one is a noun, it's construction.
Mm-hmm.
Construction is a noun meaning the building of something, the making of a large structure or building or house is construction.
Mm-hmm.
So, for example,construction of the apartment building is scheduled to begin next April.
So that means they will start building it next April, right?
Right, that means it's going to start making the building.
Okay, and let's look at some fun facts.
Okay, first fun fact, natural glass.
Mm-hmm.
Some glass is naturally formed by the heat of volcanoes.
I didn't know that. They're naturally formed by the heat of volcanoes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Our ancestors used this glass to make knives and jewelry.
Wow, okay, so from a long time ago, they used to use this material to make knives and jewelry, right? Like jewelry meaning like maybe necklaces,
mm-hmm.
earrings, accessory, things you wear.
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
You know what? When I was young, I used to collect things like rocks and stones. And
aww, you had a collection of rocks and stones.
One of the stones I had was actually a piece of natural glass.
Really?
Yeah, it was a large piece. And at first it looked like a dull black stone.
Okay.
But in order to see the glass inside, my father hit it with a hammer
uh-huh.
and shattered it. into many small pieces, and it was a black volcanic glass. So it was a black glass from volcanoes.
So that's also natural glass, right?
That's right.
That's amazing. But when you hit it with the hammer, it's shattered into pieces. Wouldn't it be dangerous to touch?
That's right. Some of the pieces were very sharp.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember after my dad hit it with a hammer, I think I cried a little bit. Because my dad had broken my rock.
Okay, but is it beautiful though?
It is quite beautiful. I can see how it can make nice jewelry.
Oh, okay, I see. Okay, and let's look at our next vocabulary word, ancestor, and that is a noun. Ancestor just means that your family from many, many, many generations ago, like a long, long time ago. So, for example, Alex has returned from a trip to Africa where his ancestors lived. So maybe in his family, a long, long time ago, there were some people, maybe grandpa lived over there, right?
That's right. So some of my ancestors come from Ireland.
Oh, I see. Very interesting. Okay, let's look at another fun fact about glass. Recycle glass.Glass can be recycled repeatedly without losing quality. And it's one of the easiest materials to reuse. Wow, I didn't know that. So you can keep on recycling this material and it will not lose anything in its quality. That means the material will not get worse, right? It will keep its quality just as good as before.
Just as strong as before.
Exactly. Most new glass contains some amount of recycled glass. So that means everything we see right now, maybe our windows or like windows in our car, the mirrors, all of those things, maybe they have a little bit of recycled glass, right?
Right. So that's why we have recycling bins for glass.
That's right. Oh. And I definitely recycle glass, you know, like black glass bottles too. Mm-hmm. How about you? Do you recycle too?
I try to recycle?
What's I try to recycle? It's either you recycle or you don't.
Well, depends how close the recycling bin is to me at that time.
Okay, so that means if there's no recycling bins near you, then you just throw in normal trash can. Come on, Matt. Do something nice for our earth. We should recycle, okay?
I didn't know it was so recyclable. I didn't know it was just as strong when you reused it. But now that I know this...
Then you have to remember to recycle glass, okay?
Okay.
Okay, while we do that, let's take a short break and we'll be right back.
Hello, 大家好，我是 Hanny。第一天的课程简单的介绍玻璃的形成。那在应用方面呢，玻璃它因为具备一些独特的特性，像它是透明的啊，还有它的强度足以遮风挡雨等等，而成为一种常见的建筑材料。好，我们文中用到 element， 在这边不是什么元素的意思哦，而是指天气状况，尤其是指暴风啊，或者是恶劣的天气。那当这个意思解释时，它固定会用复数形。好，我们再来看单字 construction。Construction 它是名词，表示建筑、建造或是构建。那我们就来看看几个关于这个玻璃的有趣事实哦。第一个是，有些玻璃是由火山的高温自然形成的。我们的祖先用这种玻璃来制作刀具还有珠宝。单字 ancestor 就是祖先。那补充单字 volcano 表示火山，它的形容词是 volcanic。V-O-L-C-A-N-I-C Volcanic 就是形容火山的。那刚刚讲到珠宝， Karen 老师有提到耳环啊、饰品等等，那我们用到这个 accessory 这个字，我们在另一课也有提到，它可以表达配件，那它其实也有饰品、配饰的意思。好，下一个有趣事实是关于那个再生玻璃。玻璃呢是可以反复回收使用的，它的品质不会损坏，它是最容易重复使用的材料之一。那大多数的新玻璃都含有一定量的回收玻璃哦。我们知道 recycle 这个动词是回收， Matt 老师用到 recyclable 就是去一加上 able， recyclable 是形容可回收利用的。那也补充一下， reuse 是再次利用、重复利用。那当我们用 reusable 就可以表达可重复使用的。解法课文中。
windshields. Car windshields were originally made with regular glass, which could shatter and cause harm in the event of an accident. As the story goes, car manufacturer Henry Ford himself was hurt by broken glass in an accident and was motivated to find something better. In 1919, Ford's company was among the first to use a special, stronger type of glass for windshields. Luxury windows. Glass windows have only been common since the 17th century. Before then, they were seen as a luxury for the rich. Humans have been making glass for thousands of years. Today, a huge range of everyday items are made with glass. Whether it's used in construction or to make works of art, glass is a remarkable material and one that should definitely not be ignored.
Welcome back, everyone. We already learned some amazing things about glass, right?
That's right, and I'm looking forward to learning some more facts about glass.
Mm-hmm, same here.
First up, windshields. Car windshields were originally made with regular glass, which could shatter and cause harm in the event of an accident. As the story goes, car manufacturer Henry Ford himself was hurt by broken glass in an accident and was motivated to find something better.
Okay.
Right. So the glass would shatter, meaning break into many small pieces, and that could sound dangerous.
Exactly, and we know that glass can be very fragile, right? Fragile meaning to break very easily. And of course, if you're driving the car and the windshield is made of glass, you can really harm yourself if it breaks.
That's right, and sounds like Henry Ford did harm himself.
Exactly, and Henry Ford is the car manufacturer, and that is our next vocabulary word, and that is a noun. Manufacturer basically means that one that manufactures. Usually you make something on a larger scale, perhaps in a factory, right? You can manufacture cars in a factory, and for example, Logan works for a manufacturer of leather products.
Okay. And our next vocabulary word is motivate.
Mm-hmm.
So motivate means to inspire or give incentive or just to make someone want to do something.
That's right.
So in that story, Henry Ford was motivated to make a better glass because he himself was hurt.
Mm-hmm.
And our example sentence, his childhood experiences motivated him to become a teacher.
That's right. And for example, if I feel a little bit lazy, I don't want to exercise, but Matt is being very nice, being a very good friend, he might want to motivate me to exercise a little bit more so I could become healthier, right?
That's right. I can motivate my friends to be healthier by saying, are you sure you should eat that candy?
Or you can say, you can do it. I believe in you.
That's right. It's a nicer
way. You can
become
healthier. That's right. Okay, let's continue. In 1919, Ford's company was among the first to use a special, stronger type of glass for windshields. Okay, that's very, very good because we don't want people to hurt themselves in case of accidents, right?
I imagine using just a regular glass like we use for a window as a car windshield sounds like it'd be pretty dangerous.
Exactly, especially if you're in the driver's seat and the windshield is broken. What would happen to the driver? Okay, the next fun fact about glass is luxury windows.
So luxury is an adjective, meaning very high-end or expensive, something that maybe only very rich people can afford to buy or to have. So, for example, while in Paris, we stayed at a luxury hotel.
So that probably means that it's a really, really fancy or really expensive hotel, right?
That's right. Very exclusive. Not everyone can stay there, but also maybe has all the best things, has the best bed, a luxury bed, very comfortable, I imagine.
Exactly. Okay. Glass windows have only been common since the 17th century. Before then, they were seen as a luxury for the rich. Okay. So, a long time ago, maybe the poor people, they weren't able to afford glass, right?
That's right. So I guess I imagine you have something covering your windows, but not something you can see through that as easily as glass.
Exactly, because you want your windows to be clear. You want your windows to be transparent because you can enjoy the view, right?
I'm glad we can all afford this luxury today.
I know.
Humans have been making glass for thousands of years. Today, a huge range of everyday items are made with glass.
Definitely. You can see glass everywhere. Whether it's used in construction or to make works of art, glass is a remarkable material and one that should definitely not be ignored, right?
That's right.
And of course, people look at glass, they think it's something really remarkable. And remarkable is our adjective and is our next vocabulary word. So remarkable just means something that you really, really want to tell other people about, right? Something that is very extraordinary. So if I saw the sunset and that's really, really remarkable, I would love to tell you about it. I would love to tell my friends about it. It's remarkable.Or, for example, I've heard that Switzerland is a country of remarkable beauty. So if I go to Switzerland, I definitely want to go and tell my friends about the remarkable beauty it has.
That's right. Or these days, if something's remarkable, you might share some photos on your social media.
That's right. Okay, we do have a question for everybody today. What do you think question? So let me ask you.What were you surprised to learn about glass or the glass making process?
I was surprised that sand, like sand from the beach, can be used to make glass.
Yeah, I never knew that too. I'm actually very, very surprised as well.
So what surprised you about the glass-making process?
Well, I didn't know that you have to, you know, melt it first, you know, make it into a state where it's liquid, between a liquid and a solid, and then you change the shape. I never really knew that about glass, you know, so I found it really surprising.
I found that surprising too, and it's great to learn so much about this remarkable material.
Of course, and that's all the time we have for today though, but we'll definitely learn more, right?
That's right, see you next time.
See you guys next time.
Bye.
Bye.
好，那下一个有趣事实是关于 windshield 挡风玻璃。汽车的挡风玻璃最初是用普通玻璃制成的，那万一发生事故，它很可能会破碎并且造成伤害。据说啊，汽车制造商亨利福特就有在一次事故当中被碎玻璃割伤，这就驱使他去寻找更好的玻璃。那后来福特公司就有改用一种特殊更坚固的玻璃来做他们的挡风玻璃。好，单字 manufacturer 它表示制造商、生产商。那么 motivate 这个动词表示激励、驱使或者是使什么产生动机。有一个相关单字我们可以学起来是 incentive incentive， 它可以表达诱因、动机或是刺激的意思。老师们有聊到说普通玻璃比较容易损坏，碎掉的话会伤到人，那老师用到fragile 或者是念作 fragile， 它是拼作 F-R-A-G-I-L-E， 那它是形容脆弱的或者是易损坏的。还用到一个动词叫 shatter， S-H-A-T-T-E-R， 这个动词表示粉碎或是破碎。好，最后一个有趣事实是关于 luxury windows， 奢华窗户。那这个单字 luxury 它就是形容奢华的、奢侈的，它也可以当名词哦。我们可以把它当可数名词来指奢侈品，或是当不可数名词来表达奢华的意思。Matt 老师在解释单字时用到 high end， 就是 high 高的那个，再加上连字号加 end， high end 是形容高级的、高档的。老师还提到 exclusive 这个字 E-X-C-L-U-S-I-V-E， 它可以形容是高档的、高级的、昂贵的，那其实它还有那种独有的、专用的意思。课文最后写到，玻璃窗呢是从17世纪才变得普遍，那在这之前它们被视为是富人、有钱人的奢侈品。那如今呢，各式各样的日常用品都是用玻璃制成的，无论是用在建筑还是制作艺术品，玻璃啊它都是一种非凡的材料。我们用到形容词 remarkable， 就是形容非凡的、不同寻常或是引人注目的。这边五个重点，我们进入文法时间。好，我们来看第一个重点是 A be made with B， 它是指说 A 由 B 制成，说明所含的原料成分。举例来说， The bread is made with whole wheat flour， 这种面包呢是由全麦面粉制成的。那第二重点是 in the event of something， 是表达如果发生什么什么， 万一怎么样怎么样。像我们可以说 in the event of an emergency, 就是如果发生紧急情况 in the event of a fire, 万一发生火灾等等。举例来说 the show will be held indoors in the event of rain, 万一下雨的话表演将会在室内举行。那第三个重点是 CASB, 它表示把 A 视为 B 看作 B, 那么被动用法就是 A, be seen as B, 表达说 A 被视为是 B。那这个 B 呢你可以用名词或者形容词来表达。举例来说 Talking loudly in a movie theater is seen as rude, 在电影院里面大声说话被视为被认为是无理的是没有礼貌的。下一个重点是用定冠词 the 加上形容词，这样的用法可以表达某一类人有某种特质的人，那必须把它视为复数。像我们说 the rich 就是富人有钱人， the poor 就是穷人贫困的人， the sick 就是病人生病的人。举例来说 She devoted herself to helping the poor, 她致力于帮助贫困的人。再看 whether A or B, 它是指说无论是 A 还是 B, 那可以连接两个以上的字词或是子句。在连接子句的时候呢，句中有相同的部分你是可以省略的哦。举例来说 whether they are steamed, baked, or deep fried, sweet potatoes are delicious. 地瓜无论是用蒸的、烤的或是油炸的都很好吃。好，以上是这个讲解，同学别走开，马上回来哦。
Glass is a common construction material because of its unique properties. For example, it's transparent, yet it's strong enough to resist the elements. Here are some fun facts about glass. Natural glass. Some glass is naturally formed by the heat of volcanoes. Our ancestors used this glass to make knives and jewelry. Recycled glass. Glass can be recycled repeatedly without losing quality.And it's one of the easiest materials to reuse. Most new glass contains some amount of recycled glass. Windshields. Car windshields were originally made with regular glass, which could shatter and cause harm in the event of an accident. As the story goes, car manufacturer Henry Ford himself was hurt by broken glass in an accident and was motivated to find something better.In 1919, Ford's company was among the first to use a special, stronger type of glass for windshields. Luxury windows. Glass windows have only been common since the 17th century. Before then, they were seen as a luxury for the rich. Humans have been making glass for thousands of years. Today, a huge range of everyday items are made with glass. Whether it's used in construction or to make works of art,Glass is a remarkable material and one that should definitely not be ignored.
Hey guys, I'm Ian.
And I'm Jamie.
And today we're playing a game called Word Drop,where we have different words or phrases on these index cards of ours we've never seen before, and we're going to casually work them into conversation.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you ready?
Yes.
Okay, you go first.
Okay, ready? Let's go. Okay, well, have you ever seen the movie Mulan, the cartoon version? I saw it many, many years ago. But I think my favorite part of the movie, aside from just the cute story and there's Mushu, but I think the best part is actually when she talks to her ancestors.
Oh. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I haven't seen Mulan. Maybe I saw it ages ago, but I do remember some of the songs. Like, there was, like, a really popular song, like, Something in the Mirror or Reflection or something like mm-hmm. that. And I really liked that song, because it was really cool to see, like, an Asian-American character.You know, like, I think up until then we hadn't seen any, like, all the characters are white, and maybe there weren't even any black characters up until then. So this kind of was, like, it motivated me to kind of create more stories about Asian and Asian American women.
Yeah, I think seeing more people, like, especially women and Asian American women go into different fields, like, yeah, whether it's movies, like, or film, or even tech stuff, right, like science, Or, because still, even though more women are doing these jobs, but there's still, it's not equal, right? Completely, it's not. So I think it's better to have more representation, whether, like I said, it's them entertainment, or maybe just even being inventors and manufacturers.
I agree. Mm-hmm. More women should definitely be manufacturers. And for all my lovely ladies sitting out there right now, like, yes, it's important because, like, it's mostly male-dominated in most fields. Education, science, politics, entertainment, behind the camera, film. Like, it's mostly men. So women, get into this stuff. Do it. Because you can also be remarkable.
Aw, yeah, I think that's good motivation, right? And also, if you work really hard, right, you know, you can, A, not only have a nice, secure life, but maybe, yeah, if you make enough, you can get some nice things, like maybe a luxury car or a luxury home.
Yeah, I think it's also important to have nice things, right? Because I think, you know, some people measure themselves, like that's a measurement of success, but it doesn't always have to be, right? Like success could be anything. And I think it's important to define what success is for you because a lot of people think that it's just material, but not really. Like you need a balance of both, right? So it's really to define your own construction of what success is.
Is it construction?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. I use it in a different way, you know?
Yeah. Construction.
See you next time.